Here we go. Playing my fifth league match against Cherry Dot. What's going on? So, Herald is the only draw. There is a village and there is bridge. So I kind of want to do bridge things with lots of heralds. But how do you get there? It's Basilica. Guess 4-3 would be a bit better. You can open Fisherman, Forager, and take the Basilica points. Not that that it's a huge deal, but yeah, so getting thin quickly is kind of important. I wonder if I should open like Fisherman Bridge, trying to get a big Doctor, but I'm not that big of a fan of Doctor here. I think I go Fisherman Forager. I mean, what does the Fisherman do? What I mean is hitting 5 is not that important. I just want to have all the heralds. I could see opening double Forager. Could see that. Double Forager into lots of heralds. I think I like that. Altar's probably not even worth it here. So it's either Fisherman Forager. Yeah, I think I'm going double Forager here. Doing it again. I did that in some other league match despite not really liking double Forager open, but this seems fine here again to me. Could be a bridge, honestly. What about bridge over second Forager? Might be able to buy like Fisherman Herald, for example. I need to get thin. Yeah, okay. He has got the 4-3. Yeah, let's go double Forager. Okay, perfect draw. I wonder if it's an idea to trash a copper here. Instead of trashing Overgrown and Hovel, because I'm the one with the two foragers. Let's see if Cherry Dot buys a forager here. I mean, the only thing I'm buying this turn, okay, goes Vassal, kind of makes me want to trash copper, because like, even if I draw a copper here, I'm only able to buy Fisherman anyway. So, trash the copper, get a coin. Well, yeah, this looks fine. And then just buy Fisherman. And then next turn I can buy a Herald already. I could buy a bridge. Yeah, let's go bridge. And then go Heralds. All of the heralds. Okay, now is the Doctor time. Yeah, that is also reasonable. Okay, this is just a herald, I believe. Okay. My bridge missed the shuffle, which is not ideal, but I... yeah, no, actually I won't be able to buy anything useful here. Only 3 money. It's a bit sad that the bridge missed. Do I buy a vassal? Is a vassal better than nothing? Maybe. Okay, delaying the trashing and then going for the big Doctor seems to have worked out for Cherry Dot here. So So now I feel a bit behind, probably. Although it's not totally clear. Yeah, I don't really know what I should do here. I think I take the vassal. I mean, my deck is hopefully gonna be full of actions and... Okay, now they go for forager. Yeah. Could have bought a copper for points there, but don't think that's worth it. Here I can buy Fisherman Herald. Or Bridge Herald. No, that's not possible. Fisherman Herald it is. I mean, it could be Fisherman Bridge, but let's not add the bridges too quickly just yet. Yeah, okay. That's pretty good now. Now you should probably take a bridge, right? Yeah. Fisherman Herald. What are these cards? It's one vassal. And just a copper? No, it's a forager. Okay, so I can lead on Herald here and have a guaranteed hit, right? I shuffled, I played one forager. Yeah, okay. Yeah, this is scary. Not sure what that undo was about. Do I keep the Necropolis around? I think I do, for the time being at least. This could be something like Fisherman Bridge. Yeah, completely thin already. Which means I still have four coppers. Unless he didn't play one copper, but I think, yeah. Play the vassal. What happened here? Play the herald. Okay, Fisherman Bridge. And then trash something. Three buys. Whatever I trash, I buy like Fisherman Bridge Herald here, right? So I can trash the copper for now. Because. Necropolis gets played by Herald hits. Hopefully, I draw a Herald here. I mean, the thing I have going for me is I have these heralds, which allow me to play more bridges. So I might still be fine. You can do like bridge herald here. That would be the greedy thing to do. In theory, you can then play all your heralds, but your deck is a bit thin, so the vessels run the risk of getting drawn and not being able to discard anything. I guess the other thing you could do is just like Fisherman Bridge Herald, maybe. Even double Herald Bridge is a thing you can think about. Did I miss some free Basilica points along the way? I hope not. Okay, this must be Herald. Okay, good. Play the Necropolis. Okay, nice. So, play these bridges, certainly trash these coppers, right? I mean, at some point, Forager probably has to kill Forager. The problem with the Forager is also it might get revealed by Herald at an unfortunate time, but I think it's still more important to get thin here, and then, well, if it happens, so I have to trash something useful, so be it. So what do I take here? Five buys, that's kind of nice number of buys to have. Bridge. Fisherman, Herald is my first idea. I mean, I have three actions. I could go greedy and go four bridges here, but I think at this point I kind of like my position somehow. So I think I'm taking three bridges and two heralds here. Then what does that mean? You get the last bridges. You get the last bridges. I mean, winning the bridge split would be kind of nice. I think the first buy is a fisherman. It's always a fisherman, right? And then bridge, bridge, herald, herald. I've kind of decided on that. Wait, what? I thought I have one more buy. Well, I guess these buys are still fine, but it's a bit weird. Yeah, I only had five buys. Oops, I could have gone triple bridge, double herald then. Yeah, maybe fisherman is fine as well. I mean, I need some economies despite having five bridges, but this was not intended. This was not intended. Okay, let's see what you take here. You have to be careful with the piles. I have seven buys. No, I have five bridges, right? So I have eight buys. I have eight buys even, okay. This hand looks pretty much perfect. This my last copper can't get revealed by Vessel or Herald. And I have this copper in hand, so I can trash it to Forager if it gets if Herald reveals it. And even the second, I can trash the Necropolis as well, most likely. Don't think I need the actions anymore. All these heralds should hit. Okay. Now if you take more bridges, what did I say? I have eight buys. So you have to be careful emptying bridges. There's also a museum to take into account. So if I trash my last copper, I lose 2 points. The thing is, three bridges don't do anything for you if you don't take more heralds also. And then the piles are dangerously low. So yeah, I think I'm in a good spot here. Yeah. Bridge, bridge, herald, herald. Okay, so this basically plays for, and the province. Okay, you can afford province. I have eight buys, 3, 5, 6. If I go double province, well, let's just play. I think I have to lead on herald here. And again. Okay, so what do I trash? I mean, I can buy lots of duchies, right? No, not, I have eight buys. So if I buy fisherman, fisherman, herald, herald, bridge, I have two buys left. If I buy province duchy, that's 13 points. So I don't actually win. Right, it's 9 plus 4, 13. Why am I? It's damn basilica. 13 points only. 5 bridges, 6 buys, 2 foragers, 8 buys. If I go double province instead, it's 15 points. But I'm trashing stuff. I am trashing stuff. I only have one vessel, right? Yeah. Can I? This is kind of tricky. I mean, I could trash a vassal here. Can I double province? I can double province. If I play all of my five bridges, yeah, then I already have it. So if I trash vassal and say one herald, I don't know if that's feasible, then I don't lose any points. And then I have eight buys, 6, 7, 8. Two provinces give me 15 points, and then I would win, in fact. But this also kind of kills my deck now. How many? It's kind of tricky, huh? Don't think I should do that. I think I should go Just something like lots of provinces and play for another turn, because I'm not sure I'm getting through my deck with Trashing Vassal and a Fisherman. No, a Herald. It must be a Herald because I only have one Fisherman. No, wait, I bought one last turn, right? I have more Fishermen. What am I talking about? How many Fishermen did I play last turn? Place a Fisherman, place a Fisherman. So I could trash a Fisherman. But I only have one copper left. So I think I'm trashing this vessel, in fact, now. Oh man, this is kind of sketchy, huh? It's kind of sketchy. Oh, what am I doing? I mean, vessel is the card I only have one of. That's what I established. Now, if, now I don't really know. Yeah, this is just on me, right? Yeah, this is too bad. I confused myself now. I would have had to trash a Herald. That's what I established earlier, but then I just trashed the vessel instead for no reason. Okay. I would have gotten there, I believe. Wait, why do I only have... Oh, I only have four bridges. Okay, so forget everything I said here. Do I trash the Necro now? Trashing the vessel now is so bad. It's so bad. Don't think you can win, though. Wait. You have five bridges, so you have seven buys. So I guess you can win. Man, I really botched this. Trashing the vessel, so bad. I would have been able to buy triple province here. All right, let's not dwell in the past. What do I do here? Trash this copper, go like province, province. Vessel, vessel. I have to have another turn anyway. Oh man. Vessel. I guess I could take a duchy. So you would actually have to get to all your seven buys. Which is not that easy. Because you have not the right number of heralds compared to your bridges, maybe. Yeah, I think I take a duchy here and then one more card. What's it gonna be? Nothing, maybe? I mean, it could be something that scores points, like a silver? I mean, again, if you draw, you just win. Unless I buy more cards, right? I could defend here with buying silver and, say, Young Witch. I mean, Young Witch is probably better than silver anyway. Yeah, so silver, Young Witch actually prevents losing. I think I should do that. Or some other cards, but let's go here. Nothing else. I mean, this is enough crap already. As can be seen by this hand. Yeah, man, I threw this game, I think. But I don't think you can win now, right? You have seven buys. And maybe you also have the same problem as me, that you have to trash something that scores points if you play your Forager. And then you can only empty and buy one province. And that's not enough points. Yeah, but I have a pretty scary looking hand to start my turn with. Why did I trash that vessel? That was so bad. Just confused myself. Yeah, I think I would have gotten there had I trashed the Herald. I had some spare actions in the end. A draw looked also fine. But okay. Yeah, my deck is pretty bad now, right? I have the silver. I have this duchy. I still have lots of action cards that are useful, but yeah, this Herald needs to do some work here. Six buys only. So you have one more bridge in hand, right? No. Where is your. Ah, you didn't play your Forager. That's kind of interesting. Yeah, maybe. Maybe it makes sense. You can go triple province here. But that might lose. I mean, it does lose to me doubling. But doubling is not so easy anymore for me. Adding cards now is not so easy. I mean, what do you buy here? I guess you can take more vassals, but I think you should take one province. I mean, two provinces, right? And then something else, probably. That looks like a good plan. I mean, I have lots of vassals. I might get to triple as well. It's good dirt. I could also have a good turn. Funny thing is that if I play my Young Witch, that actually scores 1 point for my opponent. But I figured it was the best card to add to my deck. Like here, I can discard maybe the province if I have the actions to play this Young Witch. Maybe I should have taken a Bandit Camp over the silver. Did I have the money? Not sure. I think I had the money. Then it was pretty stupid. I played four bridges. Yeah, I'm not gonna check that. Province. Province. Duchy. Okay, so you think I can triple. Can you beat triple? Pretty hard, right? So I think you should take another province here. And I'm not so sure about the duchy. I mean, I guess if you claim that you can outscore me tripling, then maybe the duchy is fine. Because yeah, outscoring with yeah, museum is it's not that hard. Okay, so interesting. But I can if I get my eight buys, I still have this double province plus pileout thing. So you would need to score four more points here to prevent that with two buys. So like gold altar, I don't know, something along those lines. Maybe salvager, maybe salvager. Yeah, I'm not really sure why I bought that silver. It's a mystery. But if you buy something like Altar Salvager, your deck isn't the best either anymore. Gold, and this looks like you have the same thinking process as I do with outscoring. Now you need two more points. Herald. What? You buy the Herald. Okay, interesting. So now, go Herald, you can do it. You can totally do it. You did it, I think. Okay, we don't know what's on top. The good thing is, if I have something bad on top, I can... No, this doesn't make any sense. Okay, I was gonna say I can discard it with Vassal, but... Well, Vassal also kind of draws if it has an action on top. Anyway, let's play this. Reveals a duchy. So does this make any sense what I'm talking? I mean, I can play this Young Witch, discard province and duchy, and then... Yeah, I think this makes some sense. And then go on with playing a fisherman. Shoot. And then Herald. Wait, what actually has the better odds of getting there? The thing is, I would like to play more bridges. Yeah, let's play Herald here. And more Herald, I think. Good. And now I play the Vassal. There's this freaking silver. Oh no, why didn't I play Fisherman? Why did I not play Fisherman? I kind of didn't see that I have Fisherman in hand. Okay, this doesn't get there, right? Because I'm stupid. Because I didn't play Fisherman. Because I didn't play Fisherman. Last card is a bridge. Yeah, it's because I didn't play Fisherman. Province. Province. Can I outscore double? Guess I'm taking a bandit camp either way. Could think about doing something with Doctor here just to set up a turn, but that seems kind of not doing a whole lot. Bandit camp. Can you double? Can I outscore double? I think I might be able to outscore double. Three buys. I mean, I would love to take that Herald. But then you can win with only... How many buys did I just have? Five. So if you take double... I don't think double is super easy for you, to be honest. But if you do it, you have 60, I would need 15, I would need like province. And four duchies. Might be doable. I might take one more duchy here. Vassal, Salvager, Duchy. Is Vassal better than nothing? Probably not at this point. Although it's not so clear. Maybe another Young Witch? Maybe another Bandit Camp? I think I like another Young Witch here because my deck is so junky. Yeah, I think I kind of botched it again by missing that I have Fisherman in hand. Even though I'm not entirely sure that... Hey, there's my point. That I would have gotten there. Maybe I was still lacking buys. I should have taken a province. I think double was pretty unlikely from you. I was too scared. Not a good first game. But interesting. I might forage this bridge if I... No, probably not. Probably just YOLO the Vassal. I mean, if this fisherman doesn't draw anything. You should just provincy, I think. Yeah, I should have provinced. I mean, I was talking about how bad your deck is, but I didn't really act accordingly. You could consider some doctor things here, but I don't really know how. Oh, you have this gold, okay. Province, duchy, salvager. Yeah. The silver is killing me. Could go estate for some points. Probably not going to see those cards anyway, and that might make some difference in points. Let's buy the estate. Huh. No. Oh man, this might have been a dud as well. I mean, unless you knew what your last card is and decided to lead on Vassal, of course. Yeah, that makes some sense. I think there was only one card left in your deck. Okay, this looks like the end of drawing, at least. Can you afford province? Probably. I mean, what else would be your hand? Okay, you can't. Heralds. Flipladies Fisherman. Play the Young Witch now. I think I'm always playing that. Well, unless somehow I have this win by playing two bridges and being able to afford double province, but that seems unlikely without having played the bridge. So, play the Young Witch now. Okay, I play another Young Witch apparently. I guess I discard Forage or Duchy. Forage or Duchy. Play the Fisherman. Okay. Does this actually win? Not yet. So let's play on. I mean, I have to trigger this, right? I have to trigger this, I think. Do I? Six money, provinces cost five. Yeah, let's play on. This wins, I think. This is double province. Oh, but I lose the spoils. I lose the spoils, but I can buy copper. I can also buy estate. Just another estate. Wow. Oh boy. Crazy. 2-5 looks good, but first let's adjust the score. One for me. Does 2-5 look good? I mean, I only looked at half the kingdom and saw which. But yeah, I'm gonna open supplies, which, and then get a couple of churches later. And then go from there. How good is which even? I guess it's good enough. Good enough to open with it. Yeah, I want lots of churches in the long run. Lots means something like three or two. I mean, there's only one terminal to play. I guess it's gonna be Witch for a while. And then maybe switch to something else later. Expand. Let's go witch. And now I take church. I guess I'm first player here again, which I shouldn't be. Hopefully my witch doesn't miss here. That would be awful. Yeah, church, march, church, I guess is a pretty good open as well. You can afford a 5 cost now, right? Maybe you have 6 even. I want lots of stables eventually. Okay, good. Well, this is bad. Next turn I had 3. I could pursue now. Next turn I hit 4 actually. I wonder if I should pursue and just buy another supplies here. I mean pursue probably supplies. Buy supplies. Or just buy a church and next turn probably march it. Drawing the church dead here was pretty unfortunate. Church and march it, more supplies. I think I go church and march it. Am I? No, let's pursue supplies and buy it. Okay, nice. Hitting 5 like that is pretty fortunate. Gonna go stables now. I mean, yes, I haven't trashed yet, but I think I'm okay. I did think about pursuing nothing here. Just discarding everything, which is, yeah. I mean, if I draw like that, it's of course better that I pursue the supplies, stables. Please don't bottom deck everything here. If I find my witch and no churches, I wonder if I should not play the witch. You also only trashed one estate so far. What happened? I mean, maybe double church is the better open one. Maybe even church mill. Yeah, I need more churches here with the curses coming in. Supplies. I guess you can consider pursuing because the rest of your shuffle isn't that amazing. I mean, pursue with supplies is something to keep in mind that it doesn't really... both churches, huh? This is so bad. I think I have to play it regardless. Okay, I only drew one, so that's fine. And now, what's in my discard? Okay, I think I just buy church number 3 here. So it looks like I was wrong with the churches. There was only one church, so I mistracked there. Ah, it's because they only have because they only had one church at that time. Good to know. Silver, I don't like. Over supplies. Do I take yet another church? Or just the supplies? Think I take another church. Okay, this turn I hopefully will be able to buy another stables. Is this the first stables for you? Gladiator is probably not going to happen because nobody does want to buy a gladiator. It's just lots of stables, and then probably one expand and then go provinces. Turn the bridge into a province. Okay. Trash. Okay, this is my witch on the bottom right, but I'm okay with that. I'm gonna buy another stables here. Trash. Didn't draw another church, but okay, I hit five, so I can't complain. Just more stables. Some point I might think about a relic, but not yet. Play the horse first here to not discard copper into the shuffle. Yeah, I think I like my position now because I was able to afford two stables. Well, I guess you also have two right now. You have two and I have three. Okay, I play the horse. Okay, nice. Can I see my witch even? Yes, I can. That's amazing. So what are these cards? I discard three coppers, five. Copper. Church. Copper, church. And I don't know what. I have three supplies, right? No, I only have two. Copper, church, and estate, right? Is it estate or curse? Something along those lines. Must be curse because I have two estates in hand with only one point. Okay, so I need to be trashing. Do, 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 do. I think I play it's. Yeah, just kind of set those aside. I could play two churches here, even. Maybe that's better. I think that might be better, yeah. Well, the consideration is if I set aside a copper here as well, but I don't think so. I want to hit five, so this makes this moment more likely. And more stables. One more stables, then maybe take a relic and then think about expand. Not sure about the relic in the first place over more stables. Okay. You hit seven. Okay. I mean, pursuing and playing supplies is kind of anti-synergetic, so maybe you should have pursued the horse instead. But I mean, you also knew that you had stables there, so it's not clear that you should pursue at all. Trash, trash. Maybe I shouldn't have played that horse so quickly. That was actually a mistake. Yeah, that was a mistake. Okay, so what do I buy this turn? I think I buy you. Or not. I was drawing just fine here. Yeah, let's go. Okay, nice that I draw the curse here. Maybe I should have bought another stables because I want to play the switch one more time, but okay. I think I'm trashing curse and copper here so that I can turn this estate into, well, okay, I only have one church in play, so never mind. Yeah. Can I save this horse? It's probably better to play it. There's one more stables down here, so I can. I could save it. I mean, church it. And then. Yeah. Think I like this. Actually, play only one church this turn. Turn this into a stables and buy a relic. Okay. This turn, I mean, now it looks like I'm drawing just fine. I could turn. I'm never playing the switch again, ideally. I mean, because I'm drawing my expand every turn. So I could turn that into a province already and then start turning some horses into more stables maybe. The third church seems to have paid off here for me so far. And if I'm drawing fine, I might also consider setting aside stables and maybe a treasure every turn, so I am guaranteed to not have a stable stud, because now when I start trashing these coppers, that might actually happen. Play one horse here. Okay, this looks actually pretty good for me. So these are just treasures, so I should probably play one horse here. I mean, I could save two horses. Church them is what I mean. Doesn't actually matter, right? So I rather horse so I can church more coppers. Should I province this turn already or take like one more not province? 6, 7, 8, 10. I could take one more stables. Could also not take one more stables. Seems also reasonable. Yeah, but I think, yeah, I'm so far ahead. I should not. I should take more stables here. I think. Maybe a gold, honestly. So I can trash these coppers. 2, 4. Yeah, kind of like the idea of gold. So like this, 2, 4, 6. Maybe that's crazy, but I think I am going to take this province. Take 1 gold. Start trashing some coppers. Maybe playing 2 churches was a bit too much. But okay. So this turn, ideally, I have 1 horse that I can trash into another stables or gold. I don't know how I got so far ahead here. I mean, yeah, I did have the 5-2 witch open. So maybe that's the main reason. Now you take your third church. I mean, third church earlier was something that was pretty good for me, I think. I think I can trash two coppers here. Okay. Church, horse, copper, gold. Trash this into stables by province. Next turn, take another gold, probably. Turn horse into gold. I could start milling provinces. Could also consider doubling by turning stables into province and buying province, but there's no need. Just play it safe. Yeah. I guess there wasn't much you could do there. I mean, I don't know, between opening church and marching it, is double church maybe better? It's not clear to me. What is this? Shepherd. Trashing only doctor. Interesting. I mean, draw is alchemist and shepherd and herald and hunting grounds and cavalries. So, alchemists look pretty bad as usual. I think I want to keep my estate, so I'm probably not opening doctor, but then trashing is kind of difficult. I mean, trashing these coppers is kind of difficult. Yeah, this looks kind of tricky. You can delve on your mission turns, but don't think that silvers are part of the payload here necessarily. Maybe lots of cavalries and heralds. I mean, probably lots of heralds again. I think you need to trash. The question is, when do you get this doctor? I could open doctor and just get rid of the estates as well. That's, I think, reasonable. Be right back. Started raining and I have the laundry on the balcony, so. Okay, I'm back. Double silver. Okay. Yeah. I think you want to build here quite big. So I don't like these silvers all that much. I mean, maybe I take one silver. Think I open Shepherd. Maybe Shepherd experiments even. But then, yeah, with the goal of having a big doctor, but big doctor means trashing your estates, and then what does that Shepherd do? What about opening experiment with the same idea? What about opening doctor, honestly? I think I like that the best. It sounds maybe a bit weird, but okay, now that I revealed this copper, then I can think about trying to keep the estates. Had I revealed estate, I would have of course just trashed it. But now it looks like I'm taking experiments here. And now I name copper and buy like a silver maybe or something along those lines. Yeah, that looks. Nah, maybe experiments wasn't the best because they get off the way of this doctor play. Maybe it should have been silver already. Yeah, probably. Yeah, I think I'm keeping the estates now. The problem with that is heralds, right? You want to play with heralds? And those don't go really well together with estates, last time I checked. Maybe you don't need that many heralds. Play with shepherds as the main draw, but you can't play lots of terminals then, but that might be fine. I mean, what terminals do you want to play? If you have the draw, you don't need hunting crowns. I would like to play with Jester, but yeah. I mean, I also need charms. Two estates and let's name copper. Okay, good. I think I need the silver now. And now I buy a shepherd if I have the money. That's why I need the silver. Oh, you bought a Jester. And now you do the delayed doctor again. Oh, you got three coppers. That's pretty good. I could stop here. These cards are doctor. No shepherd in there yet, though. Probably should play this. Okay, nice. There's one copper and the pasture down here, so I can take. If I trash the copper, I still hit five if I draw my deck. This is not great, so. Hey, that's also not great. Shoot, that's exactly what you needed. Right? Man. Okay, do I trash an estate? Probably not. Do I buy an estate? Probably also not. So I think I'm just buying a silver here. That discard I think was pretty big. But I mean, Chester's there to do exactly that, so. Yeah. Wait, do I have one more copper down here? I mean, it doesn't matter. I'm just gonna name copper and see. Oh, you can mission. Yeah, but you are taking lots of silvers. So it looks like you play some. You also thought about, oh, for a second, who you want to give that shepherd to. Well, at least that's what it looked like. So maybe you were planning to go like delve heavy and then mission and more delves in the mission turn. But now that you have the shepherd and no estate trashed, you should probably just. I mean, even without that, you should build here with shepherds, I believe. Okay, you do double delve though. Okay. Oh, there was a actually one more copper. So delve. I think I have 6 money in my deck now. This will be what? Either second shepherd or herald. I mean, I have 4 green cards and only 9 cards in my deck, so second shepherd I think makes some sense. And then switch to heralds maybe. Okay, your mission again. Okay, so you're not really building. Let's go second shepherd. This happens every once in a while, but I can hopefully get rid of that curse. I mean, I can. Yeah, it's 50-50 if I don't play the second shepherd, if I draw the second shepherd even. I guess I could cavalry to get around that. I want to buy. Okay, so you will be able to buy some provinces now pretty shortly. Okay, don't see. Yeah, but I have a 50-50 of killing that curse, so let's try it. And no, it wasn't 50-50. Why wasn't it not 50-50? Nobody knows. So this Chester will mostly hit your silvers, which is not really something I fancy. Could get a charm now. Charm with the idea that I can gain like Shepherd and Herald. And yeah, maybe the stealth thing is fast enough. I don't know. It's quite possible actually. Because my deck isn't really working yet. That's the problem. And yeah, with only silvers in deck, you should be able to province quite often. That's a nice shepherd given your deck. Unclear what you should name here. Probably copper, could be a state though. I mean, your goal is to empty provinces. The estates don't really help with that, despite having one shepherd. Okay, you name copper. Reasonable, of course. Do you like delve mission? Oh, yeah, okay, and then start provincing on your next regular turn, I suppose. This is probably too fast, honestly, for me to catch up. Okay. Yeah, I don't really want to trash this estate. Okay, so now what? Could take a cavalry here. Don't have a terminal yet, is the thing. Buy in coins, buy cavalry, and I mean, I have this doctor, but well, I might want to play it at some point. What's the game plan from here? Do I contest provinces or do I join? Do I score later with estates? Do I take many charms? Do I go like charm duchy thing? Chester doesn't do it for me. Could take another charm here. Could take 2 treasure maps this turn. And then say I have the more efficient payload, but that's probably not even true. I mean, I have to play these. I don't really know what to do. I think I do this and go experiment charm. Oh, come on. I guess that's actually not that bad, to be honest. It's only a silver, more or less, for you. Mission. Lots of silvers, and then you're totally ready to buy provinces. Yep. There's one more charm which I would like to play. What's this last card? It is the charm, so I have to do this, I think. Well, these cards are now pretty bad. State a state and oh no, you discarded my charm, so it was not the last card. Okay, so this is pretty bad now. Estate, and charm. Do I want to trash any of these? Probably not. So I think I have to cavalry here. Probably play the charm for gain. Go like cavalry herald. Okay, I drew exactly not the charm. So now I can name curse to top deck this herald. Is it good to top deck the herald with the cavalry? I think so. Don't think I want a silver right now. Okay, this hasn't really worked how I wanted it to. You're still sniping these coppers, which is good for you. Yep. I could consider. Okay, this is fine. Go cavalry herald herald maybe. Well, I don't need the. Could go shepherd herald herald. Don't need to draw right now, or do I? Yeah, I think I actually do. Shouldn't have played the cavalry, but yikes. Yeah, again, all this green stuff without my shepherds. This is my only green card in this shuffle. So I might as well lead on Shepherd, actually. I don't think I'm getting through here without. I mean, I'm never getting through there, probably. I mean, I will always play the horse, so I think it's better to lead on horse. Yeah, okay. Ten, yeah. Yeah, this is just too fast. Dang it. Okay. Wait, I should have played this doctor first. I guess it doesn't matter, like probability wise, but let's play it now. Top decks is state and cavalry. What is this very last card then? Another estate. So I should discard only one here, probably. Could actually. Yeah, let's discard one. Okay. Now what? This could be gain gain again and go like. Shepherd, Herald, Herald, Delph. I think I need to buy lots of estates at some point. So another charm is also something I want. It's Dubai's. No, wait. Yeah, maybe. I don't know. Shepherd, Herald, Herald. Delph. Wait, what? No, I wanted to Delph. Oh, nah. I saw. This is bad. That's bad. Okay. That's not what I intended to do at all. Reveals a copper. Okay. Yeah, now this. I can't play my things here. Reveals an estate. Reveals a pasture. Gotta play this, I think. Play this. Okay, let's do this right this time. Could start buying estates now. Do I want to go duchies? Probably not. Let's go like bye bye. Could also gain. I don't know. State. State Shepherd. That's too many provinces. Okay, interesting. Reveals a copper. Yeah, this deck is just not good enough. Oops. I should have left those, I suppose. State estate or shepherd or yeah, let's go state estate. That's another province. Whoops. Herald. Shepherd. Don't want to play this doctor. I think it's more valuable to play the cavalry if I can. Okay, nice. Okay, so this actually draws deck. Can put some horses in there as well. Touchy duchy charm. Charm, yeah, I think this is fine. Need more shepherds now. It was always going to be clunky, like green and charms and then heralds. That doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. And this is also why my deck doesn't really function, I think. But okay, it's not over yet. Yeah, I need just more shepherds now. I think I have maybe taken too many heralds. I mean, knowing that I will be greening with duchies and estates, it probably would have made more sense to take some shepherds while I had the chance. Okay. Yo, you start on duchy. Yeah, that probably makes some sense, huh? I think I play Herald here. I mean, I guess I will always have to play. Maybe I could have saved that horse, I don't know. Trying to save some horses. Playing a doctor. Don't have anything in there that I want to trash, right? Okay, so okay, this doesn't even hit. I might leave those. Go like duchy charm charm again, or rather charm duchy duchy. Yeah, these look like fine to keep. Gain, gain. Let's take lots of duchies. Okay, be my guest. I guess he should give it to me, maybe? Not sure. Is it more good for you than it is bad for me? At this point, probably not. Nah, I think you should actually give it to me. But okay, that's minor things. So maybe one of these heralds can hit, that would be kind of nice. So I can play more cavalries. This looks like a nice starting hand that I left on top, obviously totally knowing all of these five cards. I mean, I knew two heralds, so that was enough, basically. I also kind of knew the shepherd. Okay, so maybe you don't have province here. You do. Okay, that's bad. So 48, if I take province duchy, 15 points, I'm at 44. Okay. So I need like all the points. That's not happening. Okay. Okay. No more shepherds down here. Wait, what? I shuffled? Why did I shuffle? I didn't want to shuffle. Ah, shoot. I didn't want to shuffle. Okay. This doesn't shuffle. Bye 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 bye. Take. State, estate, 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 duchy. Two piles empty. And I need the remaining two provinces. In theory, I could win by chestering lots of. Okay. Or not. I guess it was kind of close in the end. Okay, we have Way of the Owl, Salvager and Amulet for trashing. Scrying Pool looks pretty good. So the question is, Coven for Payload could be a thing. I mean, it's probably a thing. Curses coming in all at once is kind of hard to deal with only Amulet. Well, it's Salvager. So I think I'm opening Potion Amulet here, as opposed to double Amulet. Maybe get a second Amulet later. Yeah, I think I like that. I mean, the alternative, I think, is double amulet. You also go for the potion. Let's just follow. See my amulet turn 3 and be happy. Yes. And also see the potion turn 4, and then that's all I wanna ask for. Do I take a Night Watchman here just to make sure that nothing misses? Or do I do the same as you and buy another amulet here? Let's go amulet. Okay, perfect, perfect. That's actually perfect shuffles, I believe. No, I guess it would be better had I drawn one more estate in here. Actually, that's not so clear. Okay, your potion misses. Wow, okay, continuing with the perfect shuffling. I have to top deck this. It's perfectly fine to top deck this. Okay, now my amulet misses. I could trash. I could take a silver and buy Festival or Coven. Or just take the coin, because I never want a silver. That's probably the best. I mean, I kind of want to buy the 5 cost here. So I think I'm taking coin and then coven. Yeah, my shuffles have been quite perfect up to this point where I bottom deck the second amulet, but okay. My opponent's shuffles have been quite a bit worse, so there's nothing to complain about at all. Yeah, silver seems like not a good card here. Maybe you shouldn't even have gone second amulet, but I think it's fine. I mean, maybe silvers at some point. It's always a typical scrying pool thing. You take 5 pools and then you draw like your deck 5 times basically, and you don't have enough payload, and at this point we might want to add some silvers. Okay, trashing a copper. Engineer. Okay. Do I want to take Festival yet? I think I start with a coven here. And then next take the Festival probably. Maybe it should have been Festival. Yeah, I can see that. Discard, top deck, trash, pool, trash again. Also shouldn't forget Way of the Owl, but that's only gonna come in when I have a festival, possibly. Okay, and I think I trash here. Discard top deck. Discard top deck. Coven. Amulet. So I have 3 pools, right? There's one more pull down here. I think I'm actually taking the coin here and buying the festival. Might look slightly strange, but I think it's correct. Here I could consider leading on festival. Amulet, owling it. Let's see what's on top. If Cherry Dot plays a pool, well, maybe he doesn't. Okay, I have three more coppers down here. Okay, this is one of them. Yeah, but also two more pools. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I also wonder if I should maybe even owl the pool after trashing. That draws a million cards, right? That's better. And then I can still make use of that amulet. Yeah. I think I still want to trash here. I think this is better. Discard, discard, top deck, okay, now what? Trash and buy pool coven. I mean, I'm so far ahead that I don't need to do anything else. The question is it better to maybe buy another festival? Next turn I might already gain the silver. How much money do I have then? I just hit 7, 9. So right now I have 7. If I take silver, 11. 11, unless I take 2 silvers. No, it's only gonna be 10, 2 buys. Okay, let's go coven. Let's go coven. Take the silver here. Maybe silver is slightly strange, but I think I'm gonna buy Festival Coven this turn. I mean, why should I? I could just take more pools and be totally safe. Take Pool Festival, maybe that's better. I still think I am going to take this silver. Discard. Top deck, I think. Top deck. Discard, top deck, here, here, trash, pool, festival. I should have canaled there, I think. No, I kind of need the third buy. Maybe canal this turn. I think you should probably leave the festival on top. That's usually how you should play with the scrying pools. Leave non-drawing actions on top. So that my pools... do I take silvers? I think I'm just gonna take the coin. Maybe take a silver mid-turn. Top deck. Yeah, like here, I think I top deck that. This engineer hasn't done anything, actually. Hey, my pools aren't doing a whole lot. Top deck, top deck. So do I want a free silver now? 3, 5, 7, 3, 5, 7, 9, 10 potion. I think I want this last pool. I think I take the silver, actually. Oh, I missed my festival. Top deck. Okay, maybe that's crazy. I kind of wanted to go. I don't know what I wanted to go, actually. Canal. Pool. Coven. three piles then. Maybe I should take another festival over the coven. Okay. Now I can trash that potion. I should have actually taken an engineer over this festival, because I have canal now, and let's just take the queen. Discard, discard, top deck, discard, 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 top deck, I suppose. Wait, why didn't I trash this this potion yet? Unclear. Trash. Province, province. Just province, province, right? I guess I can take a salvager. Looks better than nothing to me. And now I can win this turn if I draw my deck. I think I lead on festival and coven for draw. I only need to play one coven to win. Wait, is that even true? Because I have the salvager now? Yeah, I think that makes some sense. One coven, and then I have four buys, I think. And five with the salvager. Wait, no. I think I have three festivals, so five buys, okay. Take the coin. No, I wanted to trash, right? Because I said I wanted to do this. Top deck, top deck. Okay, so now it's not as trivial. If I trash here and draw, I only have five buys. I guess I can do this. Draw? Okay. Draw again? Well, then I don't have it. Do I care? I mean, I have it next turn, right? I have pools down here. So this is probably fine to leave. Wait, what if I trash province? Then I still have it, right? Trash province. 16, I need 16. I have 7, yeah, okay. This also works. Okay. All right. First win for player two. Player order set correctly. Let's go. Donate. Donate. Okay, wow. Ghost town is the village. Bank looks like amazing payload. So we can also draw with swash and witch. And blacksmith, actually. That might be efficient. It's expensive, though. So if I donate here, that's maybe not so good. I think I wanna silver donate, donate to 6 money, pay off debt, buy an altar, hope it doesn't miss, trash into Which by Ghost Town, something like that. Could also take a forager. At some point I need this forager, but I think altar is important. Yeah, that makes some sense. And the forager, I mean, do we even take the witch? Curses might be helpful for forager food and altar food. Okay, maybe bank is not that amazing. It's not so clear yet. Certainly want to donate here. Is keeping the Acropolis? No, I think I need the 6 money. Right, I want that altar, I think. Could have donated one more copper and then bought a copper this turn for style points. Big miss there. This should be a good first player board, like so many of the donate boards, but it's also easy to misplay. So, as can be seen in my last league match against Bobby DJ. Okay, so I buy altar here, hoped it doesn't miss. I trash copper into. Yeah, I also missed frogging this Necropolis. That's something. Another minus style point for me. Maybe the altar isn't that amazing. It's not so obvious. Like, what am I trashing this copper into? I'm running out of stuff. If I also want a forager, I might have to take like slay for the gains or count. Yeah, let's see what you do here. Do you also keep the 6 money? The good thing for you is you had the better split, so you can now buy a slay on your next turn if that's what you want to do. And I think you want to do that because you can play it and then next turn. Yeah, this is a bit better for you. With the ghost town and such. And buys. I wonder if I should take next turn, like. Yeah, you certainly buy the slay here. You don't buy the slay. Well, okay, yeah, okay, yeah, you bottom deck the copper, right? Then, well, most likely you bottom deck some economy and then you can't buy. Okay, good. Then you can't buy the altar. Okay, so, this could be ghost town and slay? And then take witches later. I mean, I kind of hope you buy a, or you take a witch here so I can take forager and so on. Maybe I should take a silver here. Last card is my silver. Is it crazy what I'm doing here? Because I mean, why do I need this village? Let's actually think about that. What do I want my deck to look like? Mainly it has to be more cards in it. Treasures are good. Could take Ghost Town Silver here, maybe. Yeah, I want these draw cards a bit later. I think I'd take the Ghost Town here. And I actually do take the Slay. So what do you do now? Oh, well, yeah, you do this because you are a turn behind. Yo, you take a second altar. Wait, what? Okay. Interesting. I don't really think I want a second altar here. Well, maybe late? No, probably never, honestly. Now I go Ghost Town Silver, I think. Next turn I hit 5. Yeah, I can do some stuff. Start adding draw, maybe. Need lots of ghost towns so you can mid turn gain, play the slay or the altar, and then swash for a coffers. I don't really understand the second altar, to be honest. The build up here is very slow, I have to say. Maybe something more money-ish is just better than what we are doing. But now that we are both doing it, I kind of like my position because I'm just further down the road. Okay, last card is the Slay. Okay, then. So I can. I mean, I'm certainly playing this horse. Can I put something useful into this shuffle? I can take the Forager now, play the horse, play the Slay, play the Forager, trash a copper. I still only have 5 and 2 buys. 5 and 2 buys doesn't do a whole lot. I only need 1 slay. I could top deck the swash. Maybe that's the play. Buy a ghost town. Don't really know. Yeah, I should have actually maybe only played one. I was too lazy to count my deck size because now the swashbuckler can never activate. So now I think I'm taking more ghost towns. More silvers, probably. Man, so slow this build up. There must be some way to do it better. You are slowly running out of food, but you also have the slay now. Okay, your count makes some sense. Can gain coppers with it. So So what? I have 2 silvers. It's my last economy, right? Is it? What do I want to alter into here, possibly? Could also be a count, honestly. Could be a count. What are we even doing? What are we even doing? What about this forager now? No. I don't know what we are doing. Continue. Not sure if I'm playing this count right now, but it's kind of nice to have. I think I'm playing the slay. Buying another ghost town. Think I actually do want to top deck this. Okay, nice. Now I can get 8 coffers. Hooray! I think I wonder if I should gain copper, gain duchy here with the count, just to have stuff. I have 4 ghost towns. Yeah, my deck is just better. I don't think it's good for turn 8, to be honest, but I think it's better than my opponent's. I want to empty the ghost towns if you take one more here. Maybe Trashing Horse was a bit crazy in hindsight on my last turn. Don't think you want a second Slay, given how tight terminal space is. Yeah, I certainly want to take these last 2 ghost towns here and not spend coffers, and probably I want a second swashbuckler as well. Okay, you do take the second slay. I mean, it's not completely obvious to me. Do I really want to gain copper, gain duchy? Is that crazy? I'm always playing one horse, right? I'm also playing this. I only can play 3 terminal actions. I mean, those kind of have to be alter, count, and swash, so I can't play the slay. Can't play the slay. Is gain copper, gain duchy crazy? What am I doing this turn? I mean, I said I wanted the last 2 ghost towns, but I could also see taking Swash Ghost Town here. I missed my second copper. Could also like gain copper plus 3 coins. Maybe that's better. And then I only have 5 ghost towns, which means I can play 3 and then 2 terminals every turn. Like swash, swash. No, 4 and then 3. It's good enough, right? I think it's good enough, yeah. Okay. Gain copper. Put in hand. I'm not playing the slay. Plus 3 coins. Swash. Horse. Horse. Trash. into Swash by Ghost Town. Next turn I probably need the Forager. So it looks like we actually end up splitting the Ghost Town's 5-5 if you take one more here, but I mean, you don't have the Swashbucklers, so my advantage lies in that for the most part. Yeah, I think I want to gain a Forager this turn and maybe start provincing. Okay, maybe not this turn, but soonish. I mean, I could believe that taking the last two Ghost Stones over that second Swashbuckler was better for me. Because it's hard to activate two Swashbucklers a turn, right? It is possible. Is it? Unclear. Yeah, maybe I should have just taken two Ghost Towns. I mean, you also have the Slays that don't do anything for you. But okay, I mean, you don't have that many terminals anyway. So I'm fine giving you five Ghost Towns. Is that a bank? It is a bank. Okay, now I can play the Slay this turn, so let's just lean on playing Slay. Swash. Two actions. Don't think I need to play these horses. Because I don't think I need to play the Count either. I mean, I guess I could top deck the Swash. Yeah, I could do that. Actually, no, I think I wanna not play the Swash here, maybe. Do this. Trash this into Forager. Draw it. Trash a horse. Top deck the Swash. Top deck the horse, or should I? Yeah, and then gain copper plus three coins by like bank and something. I mean, I could also gain copper plus three coins. It's only seven. Okay, so I can only buy the bank, which is fine. Wait, no, I have one more. Okay, do I want to? No. Buy a copper is the question. I think I'm not playing Alter maybe next turn. Ah, whatever, let's not overthink this. Okay, this is a guaranteed coffers. Slowly getting there. To the chest of treasures. So I can play three terminals this turn. Ideally, it's like Alter or Slay and then Swash Swash. Could trash my Slay now. Maybe. I have some spare horses, which is kind of nice. Hey, you already get a coffers. You don't have a forager yet. Now I would love to have my necropolis back, but I mean, I totally had to trash it, of course. Turn 10. Yeah, maybe money is better. Silver donate gold. Gold province. Maybe silver donate gold bank province. Bank province, province gold. Touchy, touchy. Could believe that. Another bank? Okay, I mean, you still don't have the forager. Here I trash what into what exactly? Maybe just play the sleigh. Not play the altar this turn. I mean, what am I getting? I could take a backup swashbuckler, so to say, that I top deck every turn. That's an idea. Okay, let's try that, I guess. Yeah, sure, I forgot about that. Let's put that in hand and have the guaranteed. Guess I'm just ending my turn then. I mean, maybe I find Forager here, but if I don't, I just. Yeah, I just take the chest now. Top deck the horse. Do I want to top deck the count as well? I'm gonna say no. Maybe I should say yes, though. I have three ghost towns coming. Yeah, let's do that. Seems kind of close to me. And now I think I just province. Now the golds are coming. At least like one more. Yep. Yeah, this is looking good now, I think. I could already start taking duchies because there's not much BP on the board, and if I have like three provinces and some duchies, it's kind of winning. Because you still have the two altars as a way of gaining duchies later, but also you don't have the food. You can only activate one swash here. Which means I'm getting another gold. So four terminals, so I think I'm playing the sleigh. Sleigh, swash, swash. And then either count or alter. Gains a copper. Gets a duchy. Makes sense, I think. Buys a province. Yeah, I think I'm. Maybe I'm not playing the sleigh and go like gain copper, gain duchy here. Yeah, I think I kind of like it. Maybe it's crazy actually, because. Well, I have golds to trash now as well, so. Not so clear. I should do that. Is there anything that I need to draw here? Copper. I mean, what's this last card? Is the question. It's the altar. Okay. Okay. Let's trash a horse. I haven't counted this, but it should be some money here so that I can double. I should probably double. Okay, I see my second swash. The one was top decked from Frog. Question is now if I should play altar first.
Oh, you're trashing a duchy. No, you didn't trash a duchy. What am I talking about? Reading is hard. You still have don't have a forager. More duchies at this point, maybe. Maybe you just want to play your second swash to get the chest. I kind of want to have it back. Okay, you don't have the second thing in hand. So what I think I should do here is first play a horse. Then top deck a swash. Well, I can do that later. Probably King Copper gain duchy again. Play swash. Top deck swash. Three. Go province duchy. Top deck this swash. Only two ghost towns though. Yeah, I think I just want to score here. This is province exactly. Maybe that wasn't the best. But I still think it's completely winning. There are some goals down here. Well, one, I guess. No, two. I think it's two. So can I province this turn? I think I should be able to. Yeah, I have two swashes. More duchies. All of the duchies. Oh, you can province. Okay, nice. Horse, swash, and actions by province. Put in hand. Okay, nice. So what was it ultimately? 14 turns? I mean, yeah. As mentioned, the buildup is pretty slow, but then in the end you really take off, but not sure if you played that one right. All right, last game. Patron. Patron is kind of funny with courtier, also with patrol. Can pathfind something, interesting board here. You can build pretty big again. Library draw is like not insane. What do you do? You don't even. You don't reveal those. No. Yeah, you don't reveal those, even though you should, right? Because. Yeah, just setting them aside. They would have to be. I mean, they have to be actions, and like in real life, you could, in theory, just set aside non-actions and then discard them. Because you don't have to reveal them. Which I think is a bit inconsistent with other cards. Like with rats, you have to or show that you can't or something. You should have that in the text. Whatever. So Bonfire looks reasonable. Like Bonfire Patron. Probably not hitting five then, but I just take another patron. Not the biggest fan of opening patron in general, but I think here it's quite fine. Okay, I do hit five. Nice. So what do I want to pathfind ultimately? Library doesn't make any sense. Could pathfind patrons and make them grand markets without the plus buy, aka conspirators. I mean, patron reveals. Now, what's the best combination of payload here? I also want to quit here. I have pretty good chances of actually colliding this patron with the quit here next. I mean, not next turn, but the turn after that. Next turn, just bonfire again. It's a bit weird, but okay, it didn't actually work. Yeah, because I drew the patron off the of my deck. That was what, like, two in, I don't care, but something like that. I think I bonfire over patron here. And now I might take a gold and bonfire again. Seems reasonable. Probably only one gold. Okay. 3-6. This might be a patrol. Do I want a second gold? Like, coins gold. And then take patrol. Maybe. And here, take what? Could be a second quit here. I need a real village at some point. For the moment, I'm still banking on my two villagers. Maybe patrol is better. Then I might draw that. Yeah, let's go quit here. That was a bit greedy, to be honest, but okay. Could play with a diplomat. Patrol first. Top decks gold. Okay, so what now? Action buy. Buy coins. Maybe I should take a hostelry now. Maybe I don't need the buy, honestly. Let's actually. Okay. I mean, I have to consider what I'm buying here. Because if I'm just buying, wait, not this. reveal this. Okay. If I'm just buying a hostelry here, I don't need the buy. I could do like action. No, I don't want more golds. Could go like action coins. Buy coins. That seems better, I think. Maybe I can do action buy actually, and then I have. If I do action buy here, I have 6, 10, and 2 buys. That's probably good enough. Go like hostelry, horse, patrol. Okay. Yeah, this is a pretty strong board here. Maybe we don't even need pathfinding. Oh, you have a cellar. When did that happen? Kind of want a second patron at some point, but... Okay, lead on patrol. Do I even play the second patrol? Maybe not. Well, maybe I do. Let's see. Buy coins. Action buy 3 buys. I'm playing this a bit too quickly, maybe. Like hostelry patrol patron. That's what, 13. Seems fine. I mean, I could have path found something, but okay, that's a nice patrol reveal. I think I want a green, like starting on my turn, maybe. I could also build like forever, but to what end? Oh yeah, Cellar's kind of nice. Okay, now I get it. Okay, okay. I mean, not like this, but in general. You can set up patron reveals. Maybe second patron was stupid. I mean, I can reveal it with the courtier anyway, and every now and then I get to reveal it with the patrol, but that's not a guaranteed. But okay, it's not bad or anything. So should I path find something? I mean, if anything, it's probably going to be the patrol. Could take a third courtier here now as well. You only have, I think you need a second courtier now. Yeah. Okay. I could get a coffers at the cost of probably a villager by playing this patrol now, leaving patron on bottom and revealing it again. That seems actually good. Because of reasons. Because I can get my things back here. My villagers. Do I need to play this horse? Question is, if I want to gain and play golds, I would have to play this patrol anyway. Like, I could gain and play one gold. Not sure if I need it though. Got like action buy gold. Is gold a good idea? Maybe. Not so clear though. Yeah, only one villager back. I'm not sure if I did this right. Okay, I think I build one more turn here. That could include pathfinding. Maybe it's too late though. Maybe I should just double. I kind of want to have a fourth patrol though. I could go like hostelry, patrol, pathfind something. Maybe this. You know what? I think I'm going to do something else. Maybe that's crazy, but I'm gonna go do this. It feels kind of bad, but I don't know. I think building to more than double is a bit, maybe a bit too much. Maybe I should have gone one province actually. Like province, seller, hostelry. Maybe that's better. Yeah, that also saves two coffers. Too tempted by seller shenanigans. And if this patrol doesn't draw a hostelry, then my turn is over. Well, it can also draw the seller. Yeah, I guess I misplayed that. The gold was a mistake. I think I should have done coins and action. I would have still been able to afford the same things, but with one more villager here. Because only having two hostelries in the deck, kind of risky. Oh well. Okay, you also gain another gold and another buy here, maybe? Okay, only two buys, so I guess you are going to double. Seller's also kind of interesting, discarding, well, that doesn't make any sense, right? Discarding green cards and then it's actually draw with the help of patrol, but you don't really need green cards in your deck. In your hand, so can you triple? Well, first let's see if I can draw something here. I cannot. Okay. Action buy, action buy. Well, let's see if I need the second. Don't think I can play around triple. Man, I really botched this. Action buy. Can I play around triple though? What would that mean? I go like triple duchy here. Okay, let's say I go action coins now. I have 3, 6, 10, 11. Enough to triple duchy. If you then go triple province, let's say. I mean, my next hand is kind of good, and the green cards don't hurt as much with patrol. So let's say I go triple duchy here. 24, and you go triple province. You're at 33. That seems beatable. You have three patrols. I could only go double duchy, honestly. If I go double duchy and you go triple province, I would need province double duchy is enough, right? Double duchy now is 21, and then province double duchy is 33. It's a tie. It's a tie. I mean, tripling is kind of hard for you. You played four golds. Nah, it's possible though. Action buy. The thing is, what if you then take duchies? I don't want to spend too many coffers, is the thing. Okay, let's go action coins actually, and go like double duchy. I don't know about this. At all. I could go pathfinding duchy. Two patrols are coming. Maybe that's good. Kind of like it somehow. Well, but then I can't be triple right again. Hmm. 33. I think I'm going duchy here. I don't know. Are these last two cards both hostelries? I think so. I'm still leading on patrol here. Yeah, that was suboptimal. Especially my turn 10 was just bad. Double province seller was not a good set of buys, I don't think. And now I'm not sure about should I province there or not. That's another question. Triple seems hard but doable for you with the seller and three patrols. Yeah, nine coffers, four golds in the deck. That's already 12 plus 9 is already 21. Then you only need, yeah, you just need, you don't even need to draw your full your whole deck to be able to triple. I guess maybe that's not true because you don't have hostelries. Yeah, okay. This guy's one copper. What? What is this? Okay, you go province. I have a hard time tripling myself, but double is completely safe. So let's play patrol. Play hostelry, play patrol. Maybe this is triple in the end. I should consider like cellaring at some point. The question is when. And I have so much green down here. I think I just play the patrol. Yeah, okay, top deck's a patron. Like now I can hostelry, I can. Yeah, I wonder if I should somehow. But no, then I'm not drawing back to them. Nah, there is some trickery here. I mean, first of all, I think I have to play the hostelry. And now, for example, I could seller. All of the green cards and two patrons. Does that make any sense whatsoever? I will draw another courtier. I mean, it's super likely that I draw one patron at least, right? I guess I can also, maybe I can just win by playing patrol now, do action. Oh, I need three buys if I'm gonna triple. Tricky. Action buys. Okay. I think this gets to triple, but I have to find out how. I mean, what are these cards even? One more gold, one more quid here, and two more estates, and one more duchy. Okay. Okay, one more gold. Let's do this first. I draw three golds. I have 10 money. I have 15. I play two patrons. Wait, that's 19. I only have to do buy coins twice. I can't do buy coins twice though, because, well, if I discard, if I seller everything but my money and the patrons and courtier. I draw a second courtier, right? And I think I have another gold, right? Because I played three golds at some point in my life. Yeah, okay, so I have three golds, so that's 10, two patrons, 14. Wait, why did I say 10? So 3, 6, 7. Okay, good here. 10, 2 patrons, 14. Another courtier, 18. Counting is really tricky, is the problem with this. Okay, I think this is exact. Exactly 24. No, it's not, it's 23. Money in hand. I mean, I can. I will get a coffer from the courtier. So 3, 6, 7, 10, 14. Golden courtier is another 6, is 20. No, this is just it, right? 3, 6, 7. Yeah. Okay. Wait. buy coins. 11, 13. And then no, I can't reveal the courtier for money and coins. The patron, I mean. I mean, yeah, I can do action. I can do action buy, but. I mean, I can do buy coins, and then I have what? If I do buy coins, I have 8 plus 7, 15 plus 10. So it still gets there. Okay, so I'm just bad at counting. That's the takeaway. Yeah, that took way too long. All right, but I got there in the end. Thanks for watching, everybody, and see you in my last league match. Bye bye.